Thank you. I mean, just the other day, one of my coworkers told me he never met someone as dense as me. Isn't that just the nicest thing? I mean, there are some pretty dense elements in this world. Like osmium. Did you know that it has a melting point of 3,050 degrees Celsius? It can stand up to pressures far greater than the average human. You know, I'm just glad that the humans understand I can handle the pressures of my job. You see, I'm in charge of pushing a little red button 1,000 times a day. That button then shoots out a sheet of cardboard that the machine then folds into a box. I know, pretty intense, right? But after a few months, I've almost got it down. This morning, there was a note that the human resources representative wanted to see me. And that doesn't mean good things, right? Usually when you are called into HR, you aren't too excited. You're stressed, anxious, all sorts of emotions. But this little alien, well, she's different. You see, she was sent down to Earth to study the human population and their lack of intelligence. She doesn't really quite get the whole human thing yet, but she's sure prepared for this meeting. Or is she? Human Resources by Brian Starchman for No Signs of Intelligent Life. Hello! Hey! I see you again one night. Yes! I found a tape to the red button that I push. Oh! It helps my interview to write it up by hand. No type messages for this employee! Oh! I might even frame it! To be honest, I just scratched the head on a post-it on my way out last night. You see, I've been meaning to talk to you for quite some time. Go on. Well, you've been here for a few months now, and I've been keeping a file on you. That is so nice of you. I would love to have that file as a reference if I ever decide to move on to another job. Can I see it? Ah, here's one. All right. Wow! That's all about me? That's fine on cabinet number 1 of 7. Oh, I'm blushing! And you should be. Every report in one of these files is a complaint from one of your fellow coworkers. Oh, well, I just seem to fit right down in on that manufacturing floor. I mean, just the other day. Wait. Did you say complaint or compliment? Complaint. Oh, I see. To be honest, in my 30 years of working for various companies as a human resources representative, I've never received such a large amount of complaints in such a short amount of time. Wow! Quite the accomplishment, huh? To say the least, frankly, you should have been fired months ago. But I am an avid mystery reader, and this is one of the most twisted stories I have ever read. Can I? Confidential. How? What? Did you say another?
Yes.
What happened to the first?
Well, someone had removed the dry clean only tag, so when I took him to the laundromat to get him washed, the authorities were alerted.
What did you say you did before working here?
Oh, it's all in my resume.
Right here. Co-captain of the Intergalactic Fleet for 3 years. Decided to move up on the corporate chain and become a box builder, huh?
You see, I wanted to broaden my horizons, you know, learn some new skills.
Well, pushing a button can be pretty intense.
Oh, you're telling me!
I have lost 8 pounds since I started working here.
Yes, there was the shipping incident.
Huh. The shipping incident?
Friday, May 14th. Co-worker.
That's you.
Yeah.
Just checking. Co-worker is nowhere to be found. Appears to have left work early when screaming is heard from the shipping room. Any of this ringing a bell?
Screaming, shipping room.
Co-worker, was found trapped in a box ready to be shipped to Stonehenge. The box was securely sealed and had to be kept open in order to release co-worker, who was running low on oxygen.
I was trying to go on vacation.
You see, my ancestors did a little arts and craft project in the English countryside, and I wanted to visit.
You were going to mail yourself
to Stonehenge.
Well, it was much easier and faster than buying a plane ticket, and for one, your government doesn't recognize my intergalactic passport, and
did you know that there's a little machine downstairs that just prints out free shipping labels for anywhere in the world?
Why, yes.
We are the largest manufacturer of our boxes on this side of the Mississippi. I mean, we ship all over the world, but those shipping labels aren't free.
Oh, yes.
But I have acquired at least 2 weeks of vacation time since I started working here.
That's true, but let's get back to the box.
You were screaming because
I forgot to make some air holes
and a sandwich. I did get pretty hungry by the time they got me out of there.
And it says here the box was leaking.
I couldn't figure out how the catheter worked, okay?
You were going to mail yourself overseas, are you nuts?
Well, earlier that week, I had tried just, you know, sticking one of the labels to my shirt, but the stupid EPS guy would have put me in his truck.
to physically remove each other's heads and move them onto one another's shoulders. P.S. I love the third girl talking with the Russian guy.
Well, officially, we have to do whatever they say.
I know. If my face could move, I'd cry. If I do that, I'll turn my forehead into two pieces. Well, shall we?
I suppose we shall.
Thank you.
to our sound person, Daryl Clapback. Don't you give him a